Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc! I don't know about you, but I'm enjoying myself playing this game. It's a lot of fun. Except for how dark it is. It's really dark, but it's also good. The mechanics are really fun. I don't know. I'm enjoying it. Let me know how you feel about it in the comments below. We all promise not to leave our rooms during nighttime. There's not much else to do, so I guess I'll go to bed. Did you lock the door? If you don't lock the door, you never know. Someone might sneak in. Monokuma Theater! What the hell? Mr. Monokuma, do you have a second? I don't really like myself. I don't have any kind of skill or hobby. I can say I'm super good at it. And my grades are totally average, too. My reflexes are okay. Not great. Not awful. I could get into a decent college where I'd make a few friends. Maybe even find a normal girlfriend. Which is exactly why I don't like who I am. I don't understand that now. My life is just one giant copy and paste. I don't have any imagination. I'm perfectly average cardboard cutout.
You see what I mean, right, Mr. Monokuma?
Okay.
Good morning, everyone. It is now 7 a.m. and nighttime is officially over. Time to rise and shine. Get ready to greet another beautiful
day.
Oh, that's right. I wanted to let you know that your e-handbooks have been updated. New regulations have been added, so please take a look and enjoy your school life more than ever.
New rules have been added to the regulations menu. You must be referring to yesterday's loan your ebook to another strictly prohibited. But right now, I need to hurry up and head to breakfast. Well, no. We need to say the regulations. You might have added just more than that. You don't know if it's just that one. Once the murder takes place, a class trial will begin shortly thereafter. Participation is mandatory for all surviving students. 8. If the guilty party is exposed during the class trial, they alone will be executed. If the guilty party is not exposed, they alone will graduate, and all remaining students will be executed. Loaning your e-handbook to another student is strictly prohibited. Additional school regulations may be added at any time. I really hope that we get a free day soon.
Hey, Makoto.
Morning, Makoto. Good morning. Is everyone already here?
Yo.
Nope. Still waiting on Byakuya and Taka. Byakuya isn't a surprise, but it's strange Taka isn't here yet. Knowing Taka, I imagine he's trying to get the King of Tardiness up out of bed. I'm sure they'll be here soon enough. Just be patient.
Let's see.
I don't mind waiting for them, but there's one problem, which is I'm thirsty.
Hey, come on.
How the hell is that a problem? Hey, Fumi, would you make me some tea? Huh? Milk tea, if you please.
Well,
why me?
Let's see.
Your roundish figure reminds me of the owner of a coffee shop I used to frequent. That's
this
your reason?
Is fine.
I can feel my throat drying out. Quickly, please.
Oh.
Okay. That lady's weird and rude. Apparently unable to refuse Celeste's order, Hifumi skulked his way into the kitchen. A few minutes later... Thank you for waiting. Hifumi reappears with a tray in his hand, a gentle aroma growing stronger as he approached. Finally... You could have made some for the rest of us, you know.
No way to think
I empathetically decline. You are not my type at all. It's all about law of casuality? Basic instinct in act and rest. Grr. Well then, if you don't mind. A smile played across her lips as she held the teacup delicately in her hand. Wait. She cocked her head to the side and threw the cup as hard as she could at the wall.
What?
What the? Hey, what are you doing? My little white rabbit. I hate this kind of tea. I don't understand.
Yes, indeed.
I imagine we are at a coffee shop. Just any normal everyday cafe. I sit down and order some tea. They ask, would you like lemon or milk? No. No further, I imagine, yes, I would like milk tea, please. In that case, along with my tea, they may bring me a small container of milk, yes? But this is not for me. I am among those who prefer milk to be the part of the process from the outset. The fragrance is just so overwhelmingly sweet that way. Adding milk or lemon right before you drink it is like dunking your french fries in ketchup or more condiments. Hey, do not diss that. That is yummy. Or dipping fries into a milkshake. Ooh, sweet and salty. Mmm, so good. Whenever looking for a cafe, I first review their menu to see if they offer a proper style of milk tea. And I cannot acknowledge any milk tea that does not add milk during the brewing process. If I had to describe our shared reaction to what we just heard, I'd be like, it would have to go wide-eyed bewilderment. I wouldn't have the trouble to make that for you. And you want me to go even further?
Yes, I realize it can be a bit of a hassle, even in cafes, to order offer proper milk tea. It is always more expensive than the simple tea with milk. It takes more time to prepare, surely, but why even bother creating a menu if you're not going to offer the highest level of quality?
Well, we don't actually have a menu.
That doesn't matter. Hurry up and bring me what I asked for, you swine.
Damn! She's turned psycho all of a sudden. Okay, your little piggy will bring it right out. I think he's a masochist.
I do so love coercion.
You were like totally a different person just now.
Shit.
Yeah, shit. You really went psycho there. I knew there was more to her when I first met her. I'd hate to have her as an enemy. Seriously, man, she's one scary chick. The dining hall doors flew open, and one of the late arrivals comes storming in. But bad news, everyone. There's a mystery afoot. What happened? It would seem Byakuya refuses to leave his room. I stood there pressing his doorbell over and over and over, but he never showed himself. Maybe he just wasn't there. I'd like to think so, but I'm worried something might have happened to him. What do you mean by that? He didn't say anything else. Everyone understood exactly what he meant. It might be a good idea if we split up and go looking for him. I was just about to suggest the same thing. Stop trying to one-up everyone. Okay then, I'll go check his room one more time. I'm just gonna keep hammering on the door till I get a response. Very well, the rest of us will check the rest of the building. Yeah, before it's, you know, too late. Anyway, we have to do our best to find Byakuya. So where might Byakuya have gone? Maybe he went to check the second floor of the school again. I'm just looking around for some more Monokuma coins. Hopefully there might be some in here. Yep, see? Monokuma coins. Oh, this is one of the monitors. Impossible to cook. Blah, blah, blah. Alright, guys. Well, let's see. I'm thinking I'm going to explore around the first floor first. I hope you guys agree with me. That's what I'm figuring out I'll do for now. And then, because the more you look around, as you've seen by a couple times, the places I've looked previously, I've gotten coins for. I need to go back in here, check around in there, and then come back that way. The bathhouse. Massage chairs. Using this massage chair would make me feel kind of old. What? I love massage chairs. Shut up. Rude. Lockers. One of them is unlocked, but I don't see anything inside. Yeah, and there's this Mondo left to talk to. Bunch of magazines, one's called The Lovely Ladies of Earth. It's filled with what they refer to as world-class beauties. Monokuma Koi! Sorry, I know that might be getting annoying. There's enough washing machines, but I don't have time to open up the mug. Washing machines. Washing machines. Washing machines. Washing machines. Monokuma Koi! I hope that becomes like a catchphrase for the series. Monokuma Koi! Oh, he's watching us. Jeez, I get tired of that. Monitor. I get Monokuma will punish me. Swimsuit, hang up dry. Surprise, he can even come and take it. Vending machine. Alright, looks like that's all the Monokuma Kinds we're gonna get from here. The fish tank. I don't know why it would be in here, but I'm just looking. No, I want to look. Gate. I don't want to read that there's a gate. I know this. There's a hatch on the floor. It won't budge. It must be locked. There's a switch right in front of the gate. I don't have the key, so I can't activate it. Monitor. Surveillance camera. Leave. Okay, is there anywhere else to search here? Storage room, perhaps? I'm gonna keep the map on for a second. Yeah, storage room. Let's go check out this storage room. Okay, monitor. There's all kinds of stuff piled up everywhere, and you could never get half the stuff in the whole world. There's all kinds of stuff piled up everywhere. Piled up everywhere. I get kind of excited looking at it. That's weird, Makoto. Some snacks and candy. Everything anyone would ever want or need. The fridge. Sake you mentioned. Stuff tied with food and drinks. Surveillance camera. Gets on my nerves. I feel it's gonna be on the fridge again. It's all kind of stuff here. Okay. Kind of weird that you get excited by a whole bunch of stuff. Alright, first floor done. Completo! Well, this side anyway. Well, where the dorms are. Let's go to the rest. I don't know why I did that with my hands. It was weird. I'm weird. I'm hyper. I had an energy drink. Not a monster. Monsters don't make me get all energized. Nostas. Oh my god, I love Nostas. Love it to bits. Along with the cameras. Staring at a TV. Let's go! Bum, 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 da, 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 da. This is the desk I woke up on. Pamphlet. Absolutely no desire to see ever again. Score it now. Break it. He would come punish me. I had a really bad joke, but it even made me cringe just saying it in my head, so I'm not going to. Metal slam. Dot dot dot. I really don't want to go in, but I don't want to see anything. Blah blah blah. DVD player, creepy the videos. There's nothing in the box anymore. I can't help think about the creepy video. Something in the camera to X-ray. Monitor, break it, come punish me. Okay. That's the store. I'm gonna continue searching around her. Okay, this is the entrance hall. Entirely blank. Surveillance camera with guns. Surveillance camera with guns. This is one of the monitors. Careful. It's a mailbox. What are you gonna say? The mailbox. Okay. A pretty good idea where I think he is, but I'm not saying it because I don't want to be wrong, but I'll just tell you guys. I guess I think he's in the library just because how protective he was of those archives. That's why I think he's there. Display monitors, security camera. Let's go to the second floor. Men's bathroom. Cleaning supplies. I don't see anything useful. Another classroom. Ba-ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I mean, this music is just amazing. I love this music. Break it. I'm not brave enough to try. It's a surprise. One is the same. Monica McCoy! I'm gonna say that from now on every time I get a Monica McCoy. So, yeah. That's what's gonna happen. When I opened the door of the library, I looked in. I cried out in sudden surprise. Sorry, my foot tangled in cords. No cords! No! Don't eat my foot! Byakuya! Told you he was in the library! Of all the things I imagined, this most definitely wasn't one of them.
What are you doing?
I'm fishing. What does it look like I'm doing? I'm trying to read, so if you could be quiet.
Oh, sorry. Wait, no! What are you doing here? Everyone's super worried. We've all been looking for you.
Who asked you to do that?
Because we're all supposed to meet up in the morning and eat together. We made a promise.
A promise? Can't I get a second's peace and quiet around here?
Byakuya snapped his book shut and slowly stood up, smooth and silent as a shadow. Meanwhile, the others must have heard me yell and showed up and started showing up one after another. Byakuya, so this is where you've been hiding. What the heck are you doing here, man? We were very concerned. Well, you have no reason to be. I was just reading. I've never read such a horse novel before, but it might just prove useful at some point.
Well,
what are you reading? A mystery novel.
Well,
Wait, are you going to use what you're learning in the book to betray us? Don't be so stupid. Yeah, it's just something to keep in mind. What? If I decide to fight, of course I'll come up with something original. Otherwise this game of ours will be totally boring, right? I don't like him. I'm just so suspicious. It's not often you get to take part in such a high-stakes, high-tension activity. So if you're going to do it, you have to make sure it's entertaining. His words sent a chill down my spine. There was an undeniable smile on his face as he spoke. He looked like he was actually enjoying himself. Enjoying this deranged killing game. What the fuck do you mean game? That's fucked up. But it is a game. The game of life or death, which can have only one winner. That's all there is to it. He's right. It's a zero-sum game. Huh?
Are you okay with
this? It's a part of the game theory, a mathematical model. In game theory, what we are going through now is called a zero-sum game. The type of game, in order for one person to gain something, another must certainly never lose something. In other words, it is a situation in which participants must compete for position and resources.
I see.
You mean like a game, a kind of an elimination match?
Actually.
Entrance exams, sports tournaments, job openings, most interaction, social interaction fall into this category. Everyone must scramble to attain something which is limited. For you to succeed, someone else must fail. This is also applied to school life we have been subjected to here in this game.
Is that okay?
Our limited resource is the only one of us can successfully become the Blackened.
So in other words...
So the game is designed from the beginning to force one of us to try and defeat all the others. That can't be. This is why adaptation is crucial. If so, who wants to escape, were to disappear, there would be no reason to continue playing the game. But why would I stop playing? It's so much fun. How? He smiled again as he spoke. Mayaka, I don't understand you. Sorry, I need to look at my timer. I'm good. You could pause those. I forgot I had it on auto. That sounds like if you do not acknowledge it. Of course. You do not speak like the others. Exactly what I would expect from the Togami heir apparent. It's just normal arrogance, isn't it? You talk like that, but if you ended up dead... What if you ended up dead? I won't. It's simply not possible. Who the fuck do you think you are? You know, I still just can't believe it.
What?
Believe what? That an uneducated, brain-dead, useless piece of garbage like you has survived this long.
Piece of shit.
I'm gonna fucking kill you. Like I said, I won't die. You keep saying that, but don't bother arguing with him. For him, the concept of losing simply does not exist. He is the affluent prodigy, after all. A boy raised to succeed from the day he was born. He considers victory his destiny, and he lives his life accordingly. Tests, challenge are merely ways for him to stand victorious, even if it's a life and death situation. Is that not so, Byakuya? At least one of us seems to understand.
Isn't it wonderful?
It is because I am the same as you. Games are meant to be won.
That's enough.
Are you trying to suggest we're on the same level? Close that vulgar mouth of yours.
Well, I do apologize.
Anyway, let me just tell you this. Let me just say this to all of you. You all need to try harder. If an opponent isn't going to give their best, where's the fun for me?
No.
That's terrible.
What?
It's because...
This isn't a game. Our lives are on the line, you know? To kill your own friend is
horrific.
It's horrific.
Friends? Who decided that? We're not friends. No. Quite the opposite. We're in competition. We're enemies.
But, you know.
What?
But what? stop trying to force your contradictions on me and just accept what I'm telling you.
Come on.
Yes, if you have something to say, say it. Otherwise, keep your mouth closed. Rude.
I'm sorry.
Hey, shithead. You get off on bullying people that can't fight back? You want to try that on me? So you're back to pretending to be a friend, huh? And how long do you think that's going to last? Fuck you!
What?
Is that all you can say? It's unfortunate you waste your breath on such empty gibberish.
You son of a bitch.
That's it. You're fucking dead.
Second.
Just hold on. Just calm down.
Piece of shit.
I am calm. How is this calm? Anyway, I don't have any intention of working with the rest of you any longer. To cooperate during the elimination game is, well, frankly, it's a waste of time. And I hate wasting my time.
Not possible.
Engaging in friendly group of meals is out of the question. Someone can easily poison your food. And I'd rather not become part of the Last Supper just yet.
Shit.
Quit talking like you're in a fucking movie or something.
Goodbye.
All I'm saying is that ultimately you are all free to do whatever you want on your own. Goodbye. Without a second glance, Byakuya left. There wasn't anything we could do to keep him from going. His way of thinking was just beyond anything the rest of us can even comprehend.
But...
was he serious about all that?
He was, without a doubt.
Don't fuck with
me. Well, fuck him then.
But what he said, he might not be wrong. I mean, you could say for sure someone won't poison our food.
Hey, come on, you too, Toko?
Anyway.
Well, it's not like anyone would care even if I was gone, right? Actually, I bet you all want me gone. You all think I'm disgusting. None of us think that.
You don't think that.
She's so weird. I know someone likes to play the victim, but this is just totally out there. You think I don't know, but I do. You want me gone. And I'm sure the rest of you want the same thing, don't you? Hey, Toko, wait.
I got my wires crossed there. Could you say it another way?
Sorry, I don't know why that happened. Dot, dot, dot. Ultimately, our breakfast meeting had come to an end without answering any questions. Everyone headed back to their rooms. Geez, I'm tired already. But I don't have time to take off even one day off. I need to get going myself. Free time! Let us head to the store. So we have like 80-something coins we need to spend. Heck yeah, my friends. Heck yeah, my friends. Where is the store on this level? Sorry, I have the weird hiccups. Alright, then we'll go talk to someone, get their affections up. Thinking swimmer girl. No, I think Sakia. I'm gonna go for Sakia. Would you like to try your hand? Yes. Give it a shot. 89 coins. Cool, got a ring. A doll. Okay. Lunchbox. That's just creepy weird. baseball, which was probably originally for what's his face, but he's dead now. I think that might be for Saki, yeah. Donuts, swimmer girl, I think. I think she, I don't know. I have no clue what that was. I'm gonna have to look at these. Aw, cute little kitty pin. Okay, another one of those. A telly. Telephone. Wait, or clone? What? Okay, those look like pantaloons. Oh, that's for Celeste, because she's the gothic Lolita. Or Lolly, or what, however you want to say it. What the cheese is that? Donuts. I know I could put all my coins in here, but then I'd only get one gift, and I want to get a whole bunch of them so I don't have to worry about it for a while. I don't know what that was. Thong. Ooh, I got a free one. Ooh, luggage. Flashlight. That's for the fanfic, dude. Another one for the fanfic, dude. Okay, a weird bust. More weird toys. Ooh, I got a free one. Ooh, boxing gloves. Who would like that? Maybe Sakia, because she's mixed martial arts? I'm not sure. Another doll. I'm gonna couple in at a time this time. See what that gets me. Cool, so got me something different. Oh no, that just got me the same thing. Oh, that's cute. A newer telephone? Seeds. I'm gonna do 10 at a time for the rest of the coins. Oh, that is so cute. New telly. And a pen. That might either be for the novelist or the fanfic writer. Flotation donuts. Overfilling lunchbox. Yeah, I was right. Those were sunflower seeds. Kitten everlasting bracelet. Love status ring. Hope's peak ring. Blueberry perfume. Max gloves. Staggering amount of passion and effort. Wearing them makes you want to throw 1,000 cross cut. Makes you want to throw 1,000 cross counters. glasses. They see wearing these while performing incantations help you speak better with a target spell. Okay, I know who to give those to. I know who to give that to. That's for her as well. A limited edition. It's a punk rocker shirt. Designed solely for those in control of their buttocks. For better or worse, it's useless. Oh my god. That was hilarious. A figurine from the popular TV show who hosted Lost in Forbidden Love Fantasy Outer Space. A DVD of certain footage of people reacting to various pieces of art. I don't know who that would go to then. Rose in vitro. A small rose stored inside a test tube. It's good for both hellos and farewells. In language of flowers, a red rose means passionate love. A silent receiver. A phone that, for some unknown reason, doesn't let you hear the person on the other end, and it doesn't let them hear you. Mr. Fastball, we've already read that one. Antique doll. A porcelain doll, due to the exquisite craftsmanship of the doll and its clothing, many people still collect and prize them every day. Golden airplane. A gold sculpture said to represent an airplane or a plane or a spaceship. It was found in the ruins in Colombia, dated to around 1000 CE. In dictating to some that the response is Upart. Ashura's Tears. The jewel treasured by a race super rare. Even the devil has friends, you fool. And then tears flow. Maiden's Handbag. Available only at a polished maiden road, which is geared towards female fanfic fans. Please take me with you next time you go. Sacred Tree Spring. A branch from a sake tree, commonly used in Shinto rituals. Yeah, I know who to give that to. Bojubo dolls, made from seeds and coconut fibers. These are used in Buddhist prayers. I got a lot for him. Common wisdom to make you think that shining a light on you will turn you small, but nope. It's just the item itself is the size. Yeah. Voice changing bow tie. It originally belonged to a detective who had a body of a child, but the mind of a genius. The bow tie lets its user speak a varied variety of voices. Yeah, that's for novelist if facts. Used to distribute full-length novels based on what word would look like if someone falls for a dream come true. Okay, I know who to give that one to. Red costume. Jump into this and you'll feel like you can support the whole world. It resembles some kind of Yeti creature. School crest, despair bat. Yeah, that's all we got. Okay, let's go find Sakuya. Where is she? Yep, there she is. I'm gonna spend some time with her.
This is not her.
I don't like this atmosphere. Should I talk to Sayaka? Or Sakura for a while?
I see.
Are you saying you're ready for another lesson? Very well, prepare yourself and come with me. She put me through a tough but rewarding training session. I can feel myself getting stronger. Sakura and I grow a little closer today. Would you like to give her a present? Definitely. Okay, so I'm gonna cheat a little bit, and I have a guide to what presents are best for people. So let me cheat a little bit. I have two of her two of her gifts. Okay, cool. So I can give her... Where are you? Rose! Rose of In Vitro. It's actually funny as Rose is my friend's daughter. There you are. Give it to her. I've been looking everywhere for this. How did you know? You're quite a mysterious man, Makoto. Seeing Sakuya so pleased with something I give her makes me happy. My post-training break is the most relaxing part of my day. The sensation of your muscles cooling down after heating up during a workout is the only true reward. No matter how many times I experience it, I never get tired of it. Do you exercise every morning, Sakura? Unless there are errands that I absolutely cannot get out of, yes, I always do my training. If I don't, I feel restless for the rest of the day. But I'm amazed you can do it every single day. Do I have Adelon? I can't say I've ever seen it as tough, but it's also that I can get stronger after that all. And I have to keep getting stronger because my destiny is to fight. Your destiny is to fight? From the day I was born, I've been fighting. Heaven sent me to live as its champion. That's one heck of a legend. My father, my master, and my every waking moment was spent with him learning to fight. As a child, I sparred with boxing champions and hit the mat with wrestling gold medalists. I was no match for them when I first began, of course. But before long, they were no match for me. You mean you actually started beating people like that? I'd say my specialty is solid stand-up that transitions into a grappling and strong ground game. Essentially, it's a complex approach. Anything else just wouldn't make sense. You can only become the best by reaching the top of each discipline. Then you fuse them together. Stand-up fighting, grappling, strong. Could that be mixed martial arts? You're basically a mixed martial art fighter, right?
Of course.
That's right. It's the most effective real-world fighting style, which is why I chose it. I don't want to just be the best in competition. I want to be the strongest human on Earth. I wouldn't bet against you, that's for sure. But aren't you already that best? No, not yet. There's still someone I have to surpass. Really? Until I can beat him, I'll never become the strongest. You mean there's someone out there stronger than you? Maybe I'll tell you about it another time, if the opportunity presents itself. Sakura didn't make a sound as she left. Honestly, I can't believe there's someone out there stronger than Sakuya. Sakura! Even if they're real, can they really be human? Sakura's report card had been updated on her experience. Your maximum number of skill points has increased. Hey, look at you go! I headed back to my room for a little while. There's still plenty of time left. I can't just sit around here. I should head out. Ho, I get more free time. Oh, heck yeah. Come on, where are you, Sakura? She's in the dining hall. Hey, Sakura is my favorite character out of all this. She is badass and really nice. Because you know, everyone in that room, she could kick their butts. But she doesn't, because she's awesome. I can almost feel the wind on my face. Should I talk to Sakura for a while?
Yes.
I admire the almost greedy approach you take forward, growing stronger. Now I'd like to begin training you in my family's secret techniques. Oh, heck yeah! Sakura introduced me to her family's secret. I feel like I've gotten a lot stronger. Sakura and I grew a little closer today. Would you like to give her a present? Yes! Where are you? Gloves, bunny ears, thigh, estradol. I don't have any more roses, but I do have... you. I've been looking everywhere for this. How did you know? You're quite a mysterious man, Makoto. Seeing Sakura so pleased with something I gave her makes me happy.
Hey.
I suppose I don't mind talking with you a little more. Really? Then can I ask you something?
Mm-hmm.
What is it? About when we talked about before, you said there was someone out there stronger than you. Can I ask if it's a guy or a girl? It's a man. The man that Sakura has to surpass. Maybe she's talking about her own teacher, which could mean her dad. Were you talking about your dad? The family dojo has been passed down from generation to generation for the past 3 centuries. 3 centuries? That's one heck of a history. Mm. I was born into my family as an only daughter. Male or female, doesn't matter. It is my duty to protect our legacy. And because I am a woman, I must be even stronger than if I were a man. Some would say that a woman is incapable of becoming the strongest human alive. I want to prove them wrong. Such is the way I subjected myself to such feverish training under my father's instruction. Surpassing my father would certainly be important to me, but that was just a matter of time. What do you mean? When I was 14 years old, when I first beat my dad in a sparring match. After that, I never lost my father again. Wait, then? Yes. I have already surpassed my father. I don't believe it.
Well,
I'm not sure I did the right thing. My father also had the desire to become the strongest human alive. But I can't look back. I can only move forward and try to claim the title for myself. That is my destiny. Well, that's it for now. That was enjoyable. Goodbye. Without another word, Sakura left me standing there alone. Wait, hold on. I never did find out who could possibly be stronger than her. Did she avoid talking about it on purpose? Sakura's report card had been updated. You unlocked breathing technique. Ooh. After we're done, I decided to head back to my room for a while. It's nighttime. Yes, but I want to look at stuff! Thank you! God! Sakura! P1, breathing technique. Okay, cool.
This is a school announcement. It is now 10 p.m. As such, it is officially nighttime. Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked. And entry at that point is strictly prohibited. Okay, then. Sweet dreams, everyone. Good night. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Alright, guys. Well, I'm going to leave this off for today. I know it's a little shorter than the other ones, but I have other things I need to do, and it is getting closer and closer to my bedtime. And I don't like staying up late, even though my insomnia makes me do it anyway. I hope you have a wonderful day or a wonderful night, depending on where you are. I hope you enjoyed these videos. Hope you can like, comment, and subscribe if you're feeling so gracious. I am here to provide games and entertainment for you. See ya!